Hey guys, this is Manak from Civil Center and I welcome all of you back to our channel and another video tutorial on Tekla Structural Designer. Today we are going to discuss about the utilization ratio. So basically when you design any particular structure in Tekla Structural Designer or any software or even manually, we take an utilization ratio of 1. That is the ratio of the used capacity of the member to the actual capacity of the member is maximum of 1. And the allowable capacity of the member is calculated using some factor of safeties. So basically, the utilization ratio is the used capacity of the particular structure member divided by the permissible capacity of the member. So it should be less than 1, or in some cases it can be equal to 1. And the allowable capacity is calculated using some factor of safeties. But in some cases, there are some special requirements, but we can ignore those factor of safeties and we can actually increase the utilization ratios if such a case arrives. So how can we change the utilization ratio in Tekla Structural Designer? We'll just see that. So we'll not waste any time. We'll just start our session directly. So as you can see, we have a particular building here which has been designed in this Tekla Structural Designer software. So now what we'll do, if you want to check the utilization ratios, you can go to your particular, let's see, drawing review. So after you go to the review, you should ensure that you have pressed the analysis and design button once. I've already done that. And after that, you'll find a design ratio here. So what is showing? Display member utilization ratio. Each member is color coded to indicate the design utilization. So as you can see, the members which have been coded as 1 have a ratio of 1 or more than 1. And this saffron actually, it's 0.8, which is the best actually utilization ratio. And the green also 0.4, blue is 0.2. And so these are the several utilization ratios which you can observe directly at once. So going back to our structural model, I'll just go back to my particular view of this analysis and design results. So I'll just click on analysis and design once again to go back to my particular view having showing the members which are passed or failed. So now suppose let us just make one particular beam save which has been unsafe. We'll just right click on it and we'll just click on check member static. So it is actually failing due to the particular compression bars, and the utilization ratio as you can see here is 1.472. So suppose we can make this safe if we can change the utilization ratio to 1.5. So for that, what we'll do, we'll just click on it, and then in the left, as you can see, after this has been selected, we have here certain options, and among this option we have an option of your utilization ratio. So if you want to just increase the utilization ratio, what you got to do is you just need to click on apply to auto design, and you need to apply to check by it so that you can just edit this utilization ratio limit. I'll make it 1.5, let's say, and after making it 1.5, I'll just click on it and then design member static again. So after I design, click on design member static, as you can see, the member has been passed. So this is the process of making a member pass by increasing the utilization ratio. So if any special requirement comes where you can increase your utilization ratio, so we have shown in today's video the process how to do that, how to change or increase or decrease your utilization ratio as per your design requirements. And we have also discussed what is the default design requirements and also the basics of utilization ratio. And we'll also show you how to check the utilization ratio in the Tekla Structural Designer model. So if you have any kind of requirements where you have to change your utilization ratio, increase or decrease, you can do that in this particular software after watching this video. Hope you found this useful. And let me tell you once again, we are the authorized training center of Tekla. So if you want to get trained from us, because you want to take an advanced class or you want to take a detailed class. In our detailed class, we cover the G+3 building in which we cover all the aspects. We design it aesthetically as well as economically from the structural engineering point of view, as we are consultants ourselves. So in the full course, we cover that. And in our professional course, we had take some hours and we teach professionals to clear all their doubts. So already many professionals all over the world, professionals and consultants, structural engineers from worldwide have taken their classes from us, professional classes from us. So if you want to get an edge over others in using this particular software, you can just contact us. And also we provide training on other software and courses as well. You can just go to the registration link, which has been given in the description as well as in the comment box, pinned in the comment box. You can check our courses and then you can connect with us. So stay tuned to our channel, keep commenting and keep sharing. Keep learning. Bye-bye.